तो आज के जो हमारे नेक्स्ट प्रेजेंटर हैं वो हैं रमा शर्मा। वो भी हमारे से कुछ इम्पोर्टेंट टेस्ट हैं, उनकी जो थ्योरी है तो उनके बारे में कुछ डिस्कस करेंगे। आइए चलते हैं रमा के पास, देखते हैं वो हमारे साथ क्या डिस्कस करने वाले, कौन से टेस्ट के बारे में हम लोगों से डिस्कस करेंगे वो। चलिए नाउ बेटर रमा, यू कैन प्रोसीड विद योर प्रेजेंटेशन।
Thank you, sir. Good morning to all of you and our respected teacher. Today I will present a presentation on a topic of co-precipitation and post-precipitation. Now, without wasting any more time, let's get started. We are generally discussing today what is co-precipitation and post-precipitation. Now, let me clear the difference between co-precipitation and post-precipitation. In co-precipitation, if we have any kind of impurity, then we can remove it. That process is known as co-precipitation. For example, if we mix sugar and salt, then we can easily separate it. The particle size of both the compounds are different, but if the color is same, but we can separate it because the particle size and the texture of particles is different, we can easily separate it. That process is known as co-precipitation. And the post-precipitation, if we have any kind of impurities, then we cannot separate it. That process is known as post-precipitation. For example, if we mix sugar and salt in a water, then it is soluble. The compound is soluble, we can't remove it. That process is known as post-precipitation. Now let's see one by one. Co-precipitation. Co-precipitation is a phenomena of which soluble compound are removed from solution during precipitate formation is known as co-precipitation. When the compound is soluble in a given solution, then we can easily separate it one by one. That process is known as co-precipitation. For example, the separation of frisium from other radioactive element in co-precipitating with critium salt, that the example of co-precipitation. Now there are four types of co-precipitation. The first one is surface absorption.
Rama beta, sorry to disturb you. Kya aapki presentation chal rahi, move kar rahi hai? Aapne agli मेन स्लाइड है वो जो फ्रंट थी उसे आप आगे मूव कर गए हो?
यस सर।
हम लोगों को शायद शो नहीं हो रही। हाँ बेटा, मीटिंग में आप लोगों को पहली स्लाइड शो हो रही है, उसे आगे वाली भी शो हो रही है?
पहली हो
रही है सर, पहली हो
रही
है। तो रमा, हम लोगों को ना पहली स्लाइड शो हुई है, शायद आपकी मूव की आपने तो की होगी, शायद हम लोगों तक नहीं पहुंची वो। कैसे देखो, मूव कैसे करोगे उसको? आपने हाँ, अब आपको मूव होता दिखा है कुछ, ये आपने, हाँ ये आपने क्लिक किए नहीं शायद इस वजह से। अगली स्लाइड पे जाओ। हाँ तो इस तरह से जैसे आप डिस्कस करो ना बेटा, ऐसे डिस्कस करते जाना। अब स्लाइड आई है हमारे पास को प्रेसिपिटेशन एंड पोस्ट प्रेसिपिटेशन की।
ओके सर।
ओके, नाउ यू कैन प्रोसीड बेटा।
ओके सर।
ओके बेटा।
Now, we again discussing what is co-precipitation. A co-precipitation is a phenomena of which soluble compound are removed from solution during precipitate formation is known as co-precipitation. Again, I am giving you example. If we mix sugar and salt, then we can easily separate it because the particle size is different. That if we remove any kind of impurity from the solution, that is so easily to remove it, that process is known as co-precipitation. Also, we can take the examples of frisium from other radioactive element. We can easily remove it by co-precipitating it with critium salt. That the examples of co-precipitation. Now there are four types of co-precipitation. The first one is surface absorption. Second one is mixed crystal formation. Third one is occultation, and the fourth one is mechanical interruptment. And now we can discussing one by one. The first two processes. The first two processes are equilibrium processes, whereas occultation and mechanical interruptment arises from crystal formation. Now, the surface absorption. Surface absorption is a phenomena in which impurity is chemically or physically absorbed into the surface of precipitate is known as chemical absorption. We can see here in diagram, this is our particle, and impurity can attack from outside and absorb into the surface of this participate or this participate. This process is known as surface absorption. Now we can easily see here impurity absorbed on the surface. That process is known as surface absorption. Now our second process. That is mixed crystal formation, a type of co-precipitation in which a contaminant ion replaces an ion in the lattice of crystal. Now what happened here? This is our crystal lattice, and these are two black one are impurities. What happened? The impurity take the place of this ion here and replace the red ion from outside. That are the process in which happened in mixed crystal formation, and ion take the place of this ion in the crystal and replace her size. As we can see here, there is another black impurity take the place here and in the crystal, in the lattice of crystal, for example, SRSO4 in BSO4. That's the example of mixed crystal formation. Now another third process is occultation. Occultation is a process in which a compound, a counter ion layer, is physically trapped within the participate during rapid participate formation. Now we can see here in diagram, these are our lattice, and these are the ions which trapped in between of these two red ions, the particle trapped in between her during the rapid participate formation. A foreign ion is take place in between of these two ions and take here. That process is known as occultation. Our next process is mechanical interruptment. Mechanical interruptments occur when the crystal lie together during growth. Hence, several crystal grow together and is so doing trap a portion of solution. Now what happened here? Two particles, these two yellow particles merge together and form the full-on crystal, and if the mechanical interruptment is low, then the rate of participant is also slow. These are the diagram which show when the two particles are merged together and form a full crystal. That process is known as mechanical interruptment. Our last phenomena is post-precipitation. Post-precipitation, the process by which an impurity is deposited after the participation of a desired substance is called post-precipitation. Now we cannot remove the impurities from present in the solution. That process is known as post-precipitation. For example, if Mg2 positive is present as an impurity along with the calcium-2 positive. Here the main compound here is calcium-2 positive, and magnesium is as an impurity take place in calcium. Then during the synthesis of calcium oxalate, there are chance of there is a chance of post precipitation of magnesium oxalate. Actually, what is the product here? Actually, what is product? We accept that is calcium oxalate, but due to the post precipitation, we meet a product of magnesium oxalate. These kinds of impurities we can avoid it by the maintaining high pH level. That can also help us to avoiding post precipitation and also to make our precipitation more fastly. Thank you.
थैंक यू वेरी मच बेटा. रमा आपने बहुत अच्छी प्रेजेंटेशन बनाई हुई है. फैबुलस काम किया आपने. जो आपकी सिचुएशन थी उसके बावजूद आपने इतना टाइम निकाल के लिए इसलिए किया. बहुत 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 बढ़िया है. आई थिंक इसमें भी ऐसा कुछ लगता नहीं है कि किसी को कुछ पूछने लायक बचाओ. फिर भी अगेन थैंक यू वेरी मच. फिर भी अगर किसी कुछ क्वेरी है, कुछ पूछना चाहते हैं तो रमा से आप पूछ सकते हैं. चलिए एज यूजल हमारे जितने भी ये लिसनर्स हैं, हमारे जो सुन रहे हैं इसको, उन सबको समझ में आ गई होगी आई थिंक सो. चलिए अगेन रमा बेटा थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर दिस नाइस प्रेजेंटेशन.
थैंक यू सर.
वेलकम बेटा.